Hello friends, welcome back to the second video where we would be talking about few more add-ons that can make your live class even more lively. So you can see on my screen on this left hand side there are few icons. What do these stand for? In the Google Meet, one thing that is missing is if the students feel that they have a query, then there is no button which they can press and they can raise their hand and ask a query. Similarly, if I ask the students whether they have understood a particular concept, then it's very difficult if the students just unmute themselves all at the same time. It creates a lot of chaos. So to avoid that, we can have this these emojis and the student can get to know whether the students are understanding the concept or not. So how to integrate these two features or add-ons with the Google Meet? What we have to do is just go to your browser and type Node extension. So when you will type Node extension, you will get this link, Node reactions for Google Meet, Google Chrome. This is a very important and interesting add-on for our Google Meet. And I already have it installed on my device. So if you are installing it for the first time, you will have the button for install. And once you have done that, what will happen is you will have this icon in your address bar, a thumbs up icon. If you don't have it here, you can see this puzzle sign. You can see on the top right hand side this puzzle sign. This puzzle sign stands for extensions. When you will click on these extensions, you will have all the add-ons that I have installed. Here we have the Node reaction. Just click on this pin sign, and when you click on this pin sign, this particular extension would come on your address bar, right? So now after you have added it to your address bar, let us move to the next add-on before I start explaining their usage. The second add-on is the push to talk add-on. So type on your browser push to talk extension and you will get this Google Meet push to talk. Because in Zoom there is again an issue, if the students want to interrupt and want to take the permission from teachers, they don't have any icon. So click on this and again install in your browser. You just have to click on add to Chrome, add extension. And when you click on this puzzle sign again here, you will get this Google Meet push to talk. Just pin it and you will have it again on the address bar. You can see this. Let me go back to my Meet and here is the emoji. Now, one important thing here is that if you want that the students should make use of this, then both the teacher as well as the students need to install this add-on or extension on their devices. If any student has not installed this add-on, then it won't work on the teacher's as well as the student's device. So let us go to the Students tab. Here it hasn't been added yet. So if I add it here, then the students can press it. And the teacher would come to know that the student has a query or the student wants to ask something. I hope you liked it. In the next video, we'll talk about the attendance that can be taken automatically using the Google Meet add-on. One very important and other add-on that you can use and make your live classes interactive and also get to know whether the students are enjoying and understanding the classes or not is making use of the Mentimeter. Now what is Mentimeter is, I will open another browser and here I'll type Mentimeter. So this would open up mentimeter.com. If you are using it for the first time, obviously you need to sign up. Otherwise, I am already logged in here. So I will go to your presentations. Here in Mentimeter, now let us click on new presentation. and we can give any name. Interaction 1, create presentation. The Mentimeter can be used for creating presentations also, but it is most useful for having your live polls basically, which can be integrated with the Google Meet. So what you can do is, you can have these various options. You can have multiple choice, word cloud, open-ended questions, scales, ranking, etc. I am choosing a simple one, which is multiple choice. So as soon as I click on multiple choice, you have to write your question here. So I will write, are you understanding? And here in option 1, I'll write yes. You can also have an image here. You can have you can upload an image. You can take something from the image library. You can search from here, or you can use the GIFs or the GIFs. So I will write something for yes, and you get these things that you can put if you want to, right? Similarly, I can put for no also, and if you want to have the image, you can do that. No. And once this is done, option 3, if you want to write, you can write maybe or something, but if you don't want it, just click on this cross sign and it would be removed. Now, if you want to add this to the Google Meet, what you have to do is just click on this share button and you get this link, the voting link through which the students would actually vote. And this is the anonymous voting. So we'll just copy this link from here, and in the Google Meet, I will go to the chat box and I will simply paste this link. Now what would happen is, let us go to the Students tab and see. This is the Students tab. I will see in the chat box, this is the link that is here. So as soon as the student clicks here, the student would be redirected to this question. There is no need of the student for logging in. And the student can simply click on the option that he likes, yes or no, and it would be submitted. Let us go to the Teachers tab and let us see what are the answers here in the Mentimeter. You can see that these are the answers that the teacher is getting here from the Mentimeter. Apart from this, there is one more way of giving your voting using Mentimeter is, go back to Mentimeter and here you can see this is the code here. So it is 373949. You can give this code to the students and tell them to cast their vote using this. So how they'll do this? You just type in the Google Meet this code 373949. Let me check this and ask the students to go to the Mentimeter, and when they'll go to Mentimeter, there is no need of signing up or logging in. They can simply type this code here 373949 and they can cast their vote. So these are the two ways as to how the students can cast their vote. It's better to give the students the link, and how the student would know the result, the teacher would get to know the result. The teacher has to go to their Mentimeter account, and there in your presentations, you just open this and you will get to know how the results are being displayed, whether the students are going for yes or no. So you can keep this Mentimeter opened up also, because for downloading the results, you need to go for upgrade. And while the students are giving out their polls, you can also show them how the class has been polling on the poll that you have just created. For that, on the Mentimeter website, you have to click on this present button. As soon as you click on this present button, the Mentimeter screen would be there as the full screen. And on this right hand side, there would be a live thing as to how the students have been polling. So as soon as a new student polls in, this count is bound to increase. So in this way, you can add interaction for your students via the Google Meet when it is integrated with this Mentimeter. Thank you.